Hi, Lee Ellis here with this month's Leading with Honor Coaching. Well, we're outside today and it's a beautiful day. You know, I always enjoy being outside because outside is like freedom to me, and having spent 5.5 years locked up, being outside has a special meaning. But also at this time of the year, the 4th of July, our Independence Day is coming, and that's very special to me also because it's about freedom. You know, it's good that we have backyard barbecues. My family's going to be having one on the 4th. We always go to Zeb's and pick up the wonderful barbecue and hash there and get together. We enjoy that. And parades. And lots of times we watch the concert on the 4th of July evening from the National Capitol. Those things are very important. But it's also important to reflect on our freedom and the Founding Fathers and what they did to bring us that freedom, and what are our responsibilities as leaders and as citizens toward that freedom also. You know, the Founding Fathers knew there was a lot at stake. They knew that Mother England was not going to give up easily, having the largest and best organized army in the world. They were probably going to come after them. So as they signed off on the Declaration of Independence, there was so much at stake, and they were well aware of that. But they also wanted freedom. Well, we all want freedom. We enjoy it. We want to be a part of it. But it does have responsibility, and there's some accountability that goes with that. You know, during my 5.5 years as a POW, we really wanted to be outside. We wanted freedom. We wanted to walk out of there. But we had our responsibility there that was above ourselves. We could have signed off on some anti-U.S. propaganda and walked out of there. But we didn't. We stayed because we had a responsibility to support our country and our fellow POWs. And so as we think about and reflect on the 4th of July, this year I want us to think about freedom and responsibilities that go with it. So here are 3 or 4 things that I think we can all do. First of all, is to live and lead with honor ourselves. We need to pay attention to what we say and how we do things because our honor is at stake. And also, we need to be training and teaching this next generation of leaders coming behind us what honor is about character, about courage, and about commitment. Those are the core of courageous accountability, and we need that so desperately in our society today. And if you're really struggling, well, how can I dig into this honor thing? Well, go to our website and download the honor code. There are 6 articles of what it really means to live and lead with honor. And I'll tell you, they're not easy. It is a battle. Secondly, aside from training and developing this younger generation, we can be very conscientious about holding our elected officials accountable, getting involved, knowing what's going on, finding out all the facts about issues so that we can vote and hold our elected officials accountable. Regardless of your political party, the way you look at things, think about what's best for the country, what's best for preserving the freedoms that we so much enjoy, and then become smart about that and help others become more aware of what it will take for us to remain a free country. And finally, continue your own efforts with yourself. It always has to start with yourself. The battle in within yourself to put others first. Now, we all have a strong ego that puts ourselves first, and most of the time that's okay. We do need to do that. But there are times when we need to put others first, when we need to put the country first, and think of that, because that's what makes for a civilized society. That's what enables to have an environment where honor is so important and so well. Such holding us together in such a way that it makes it a good place to live. You know, we all want to be a good team, we want to be involved with a good organization, and we want to be part of a good country. And so we can take responsibility for that ourselves. You know, I'd like to close out reminding us what's at stake. It is about our freedom. It is about our future. It's about the legacy that we leave for the next generation. And so I couldn't say it better than what the signers of our Declaration of Independence said in the closing line of that famous document. And they said, "And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of divine providence, we mutually pledge to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor." Sacred honor. I hope that you will live and lead with honor and help preserve our freedom.